In the last lesson, we learned the process of multiplication. In this lesson, we will see some interesting examples on this. Everyone has gone to the fair. The fair has a variety of entertainment. There is a huge Ferris wheel in the fair. This Ferris wheel can seat 22 people at a time. The Ferris wheel operates 12 times a day. Raju and Bablu are looking at this Ferris wheel. Raju asks Bablu, "How many people can sit in this Ferris wheel in a day?" Children, can you find the answer to Raju's question? At a time, 22 people can sit in it. And the Ferris wheel operates 12 times a day. How do we write this in the form of multiplication? 12 times 22. But we have only learned to multiply a two-digit number with a single-digit number. How do we calculate this now? Come, let us learn to multiply two-digit numbers. How can we split 12, 10 and 2? We will write it this way. And how can we now split 22, 20 and 2? We will write it this way. Now we first multiply the 2 of 12 by 20 of 22. 20 times 2 is 40. We will write this answer here. Now, we multiply 10 by 20. 20 times 10 is 200. We will write this answer here. Now, we multiply 2 of 22 by 2 of 12. That's 2 times 2 is 4. Finally, multiply 2 of 22 by 10 of 12. What would we get? 20. Now it's very easy. Adding 200, 40, 20 and 4 is our answer 264. Following this method, we got 12 times 22 is 264. Got it. A total of 264 people can sit in the Ferris wheel in a day. While going around the fair, Raju and Bablu stopped at the game stall, which had the balloon bursting game. Bablu asked Raju, "Why not buy themselves and for their friends tickets to this game?" Bablu and Raju counted the number of people. Including both of them, there are 17 people. The cost of one ticket for the balloon bus game is rupees 15. Raju and Bablu are unable to calculate how much money they will have to pay to buy the required number of tickets. Come children, let us help Bablu and Raju once again. This time, let's learn to perform this multiplication using a different process. First, we will write multiplication this way. Now, we will multiply 5 of 15 by 7 of 17. Did you get it? 35. Can we write both the digits of 35 as a single digit number? No. So, what shall we do now? We will use carryover to write 3 of 35 as a carryover and write the 5 in units place like this. Now, we multiply 1 of 17 by 5 of 15. Got it? 5. But we also have 3 of the previous carryover. So what shall we do now? We will add 3 and 5 to find the answer. Done. 8. We will write it like this. Now we will cancel the carried over 3 so that we don't make a mistake of counting them again. Now we will multiply the 1 of 15 by the digits of 17 from right to left. We will write it in the second row. Before starting the multiplication process, we write a 0 like this in the unit space. First, we multiply 1 by 7. Is it done? 7. We will write it like this. Now, finally, 1 is multiplied by 1. That's 1. We will write it like this. Now it's very easy. Simply add 170 to 85. What do we get? 255. Doing this, we get our answer 17 15s are 255. Raju and Bablu will have to pay a total of 255 rupees. Raju and Bablu and their friends had a lot of fun at the fair. Children, in this lesson we have seen some interesting examples on the process of multiplication. In the next video, we will see some common mistakes we make in the process of multiplication.